Everyone seems to know Krampus these days. But do you recall the strangest German Christmas character of all? Belschnickel? Also known as Christkinkle, Belznickel, Pellnickel, and sometimes the Christmas Woman when he arrives dressed in women's clothes, Belschnickel is an impish, crotchety, bearded man wearing furs. Also, sometimes a long tongue. In southwestern Germany, he is a companion or sometimes servant of St. Nicholas. Just before Christmas, Belschnickel will knock on the windows to a house to come inside, and then judge who is naughty and nice by asking children in a high voice if they were good this year to recite a Bible verse, and then he will throw some candy on the ground. If a child fails this test, such as lying about if they behave themselves or jumping too quickly at the candy, Belschnickel beats them with birch tree switches. If the child behaves, they get some candy, cakes, or nuts that he carries in his pockets. This is all so German. Europe is full of these bearded, horned, often long-tongued, child-whipping, and kidnapping, let's call them anti-Santas, that are made to make children behave. Although he has a lot of similarities to Krampus, Belschnickel was probably based on Neck Ruprecht, or Servant Rupert, another companion of St. Nicholas who appeared in records in Germany in the 1600s. According to the Brothers Grimm, Disney's favorite well of potential IP, St. Nick's sidekicks probably all descended from ancient pre-Christian beliefs in mischievous house elves. Which, yes, means this guy isn't exactly as novel and original as you may think, parents on Instagram. In the early 1800s, as German and Dutch immigrants made their way to America, so did St. Nick and his rogues gallery. In the more Dutch New York City area, it was a Santa Claus region. But in the German-filled Philadelphia area, it was Belschnickel who was the king of Christmas. Philadelphia had gangs of Belschnickels that would roam the streets at Christmas, punishing children for bad behavior. However, post-Civil War, as New York City outgrew Philly and became the immigration and media center of the country, Santa Claus' influence starts to spread nationally. But there was a moment where if history went in a different way, there was a chance you could be taking your kids to sit on this guy's lap and maybe get whipped. Today, Belschnickel can mostly be found in his original home of Southwest Germany, still in some areas of Pennsylvania, and like many exiled fiendish Germans, in pockets of South America. And yes, for all you Office fans, in that one Christmas special, Pennsylvania Dutch Dwight Schrute dresses up as Belschnickel. Good research, job writers. So frohe Weihnachten. And if you hear a knock on the door this Christmas and aren't brushed up on your Bible verses, do not open that.